now up 6-0. I know we're expecting a good battle here tonight. 7 games in 8 days is a lot of games to be played back-to-back. But Northeastern is enjoying their trip thus far and getting some competitive basketball from some Canadian teams Canadian competition up here. So that should be a good one.
Starters for the BGs tonight, because they got the Monsieur up front, along with the Moid Mail, John Payne, Mescal, Mike Dr. Kane, back with the GG starters for the Northeastern Huskies, Andy Ford, Jonathan Lee, and Zach Ball, along with Reggie Spencer. Joel Smith. Joel Smith, of course, second in team scoring last year, averaging almost 13 a game, and almost 15 a game for Jonathan Lee, also in the starting lineup. So those two players, if you look at wide season, we have a little conference at the scores table there. Not sure what it's about. Both coaches are at the scores table. Perhaps it's an eligible player. It could be a whole bunch of things. I can't tell from here. Or here.
I think it might have to do with that last play, Greg. So it was a foul on the Ottawa UGGs and a basket for Northeastern, but it looks like the basket was waved off, so it must have been an offensive foul on the play. So I think the coaches were just explaining it was an offensive foul on the play, so the score is actually 4-0 Northeastern at that point. So definitely our first exposure, obviously, to Northeastern up here in Ottawa. Very exciting team. Look out for number 30. Zach's all a freshman this year, but very consistently so far this road trip here for the Huskies, and obviously number 44, Greg Spencer, body for Northeastern, scoring 14 points and 7 boards for the Huskies last night against McGill.
Big bucket there, but it's really 7-3. Just over 2 minutes into this thing. Always Mail, one of the promising rookies for the DG's game yesterday, just fired a three on the other end. Mike Laffer-Kane does not get the shooter's role as the GG's trying to pull it to within possession. Huskies bring the board down. Paul Smith directing traffic. He's a 6'4 senior out of Vander, Texas. Up inside, turn around, Spencer. Good defense there by the GG's. Mike Laffer-Kane had 17.6 assists and 4 boards yesterday. Nice step for him, a pretty consistent player. It's really pulled him into.
It'll be interesting to see Spencer having a really good game yesterday against McGill. Big post there inside. Ottawa U's a little undersized. Do have a couple of post players. Notably, Gabriel Gonzalez-Zubir, number 4 for Ottawa. But otherwise, Ottawa picked up on a 4 guard, 1 post line. Guard 4 combo, using their speed instead of that side inside. So it'll be interesting to see if Northeastern can hurt Ottawa inside today. See, Ottawa's shooting is going to counteract that post play.
Pretty good right there at Johnny Bainscal with a pick at the top of the key, finding Vickers for that red and blue 3-pointer on the end of the GG's pick. Their first lead of the game. It is 8-7 coming up on the 4-minute mark. One team up so far, and that's against the Huskies, not for the GG's. They just get back in the office. Johnny Bainscal immediately drops in defense. Pass inside, a nice one too. Behind his back, but he just ran out of time.
We note that Canadian teams play under FIBA rules, Greg, so we go with the 24-second shot clock, and we run play a 14-minute quarters in Canada. Canadian CIS basketball, Inter University Sports, but today going with a 30-second shot clock. And 2:20 and halves to suit the American play. So it's been interesting too, just to see how both teams track under the American set of rules.
One thing I'm not sure that I like confirm before the game is whether it's going to be a 10.5 or an 8. So I guess we'll see what happens there. And teams are going to take a quick timeout. We will take a quick timeout as well. I'm going to just a reminder, GG Ottawa is the Twitter address. Go and do it as a hashtag. And we'll be back right after a 2-minute break. Welcome back to GG's Basketball, everybody. Jimmy mentioned if you want to tweet at us before, we've got our first tweet here from NUHF, and yes, NUHF, you can interact with the foreign play-by-play guy. We might even throw a couple of Canadian terms. Like yesterday, I mentioned hip check for a crazy foul. Some of the young tweeters like that. Yeah, hey, the foreign play-by-play guy. A lot of fun. It's encouraging to get your boots in. Ball to the backboard, they fight for it. GG's trying to come up with it, we got a jump ball on that is going to stay. GG's on the play. Angle put them on the pile. Yes, it was Gabriel going to the Drew, and of course it's going to be him, Mr. Blue Baller himself, working hard.
For Eastern fans who don't know about the Ottawa U roster, number 8, Johnny Verhaen, that's still coming at the top of the screen here. He's our top scorer here at Ottawa U and poured in 22 first-half points against Central V yesterday. As we're going to see if he finishes the basket, he'll lay it down low. Keep an eye on Johnny Verhaen, scout number 8 for Ottawa. He's a really top-notch scorer and not just a shooter, Greg. Last year, Johnny left out sniper from outside. This year, we saw yesterday driving into the key, so we'll see if he attacks the inside, just the inside today as well.
10 or 15 pounds of muscle over the summer. Definitely will help his inside game this year, and here he is with the ball. He's got Quincy Ford on him. Ford, of course, one of the top players for NU last season, third on team scoring, averaging almost 12 per game. A drive inside, back out. 9 seconds on the shot clock. Caleb Gatt has the shot block. Great perimeter defense there by the Huskies. As we've come up on the 7-minute mark, 10-7 GG's Leon. The Huskies last year, 9-9 in conference play. Looking for a bit better things this year. Talking to the comments out before the game, and obviously strength of schedule is a big deal when trying to get your trying to burst that bubble and get your RPI up, and beating St. John's a couple of years ago by 20, and beating Indiana, one of the top D1 schools, and only major school like Huskies. The GG is a game high now, tied for game high, 13-9 lead, as we are coming up on the 7-minute mark of the first half. Jonathan Lee has that one swing cross court back into the big man. Spencer trying to go back the second time. It's good. It's a 2-point.
The size and length of athleticism of Northeastern, so we're trying to see that here today. Post play by Northeastern, and how that can be a key to this game. Just saw Johnny Brain still knocked on a three on the other end. For the GGs,
That was a release, but
rattling out that strike.
Smith yesterday had 16 points. Or rather, I'm looking at the category. Greg is in off-season mode still. 11 points, 3 rebounds, and with 3 of 6 from the 3-point line. Good shooter. We'll watch for that, obviously, this evening. He's looked a lot of time here on this possession. Spencer playing good defense there, trying to stop that ice screen. And we've got a foul. McCoy again trying to get in the middle. He'll go to the line where he led the league last season. Better than 82% from the stripe. A blip in the sort of free throw bell curve last season, considering the GG's shot in the high 60s. Players to work on. But for game ball, it was a non-shooting foul. Could break down his defender. Last second dish to Quincy, Ryan Quincy for Caleb Pata. Mixed up the number 12.
I think we've got a former GG in the building. Gibson from
people making their way in here this evening. I like this game, Mark Bielwick looking as well. Timo Baldich in the front row. The alumni here in the center. Supporting the team. That was the second team foul, by the way, on the Huskies. Both teams calling for a little bit of time.
With the GG's leading 13-11, it's 11-35. First half, we're going to take 30 seconds.
Welcome back, everyone. We've come up on the 9-minute mark of the first half. 13-11 GG's. Holding on to the lead here. Turnover as that pass gets into GG's bench. We were just talking about the tournament appearances for the Huskies. They're in a mid-major conference. Last tournament appearance was 1991. When they lost in the first round, that was in Syracuse. Back when Syracuse was a stadium to hold the tournament, to hold regionals. At 50,000, the Carrier Dome was unfortunately not big enough to hold the final four. Just goes to show you how far it's come.
Absolutely. Interestingly enough, I noticed that he's going deep into the shot clock, so they're the Northeastern building, not letting them set up, run the plays they want, which is a testament to Northeastern's defense. Or the GGs are kind of stalling a little bit on on offense and not getting the looks that they want. So it'll be interesting to see if Coach Aaron wants to score earlier on the shot clock. GZ's hanging out, kind of taking the last second possible shot there to get their shot off. So let's get this possession goes right here, Greg.
That was a possession of promise there when Abel Gonsi got it inside to just get a nice pass. Working a few more of those, and they might have a significant lead heading into the second half. Still 13-11 here. GG's control with 18 on the shot. Ball goes in. Mike Lafferkane. Off the screen, Dr. Hamas got a look and creates some space. Step back, jumper, back up her nose. Hussey's come back with a rhythm. Tough shot there for Johnny, although very quick in creating that space. Post quick move by Johnny Lee. He's a senior out of Flint, Michigan, also where former Raptor Morris Peterson is from. He patrolled the Raptors court, but I believe it was 08 when he was traded to Morris
Peterson. That's right.
First throw goes down to Jonathan Lee. Second one goes to the senior, and this game is tied. Steps back indeed to guard Mike Lafferkane. Stepping into that is Caleb Agata. Johnny with the ball. Vic left, one right. Vic still really trying to shoot back three. Just to pick up the dribble. Agata back to Lafferkane. He thought about the long one. GG's running out of time. Agata 18-footer back iron. Two positions in a row, GG's forced it up for a jump shot.
So, foul on number 15, Matt Nelson, Greg, for Ottawa, another rookie. Perhaps a mistake, if you will, but he had to stop the fast break. Northeastern's behalf. Out of 13. 9:55 left in the first half. Expect the team to go pretty deep into their benches today, Greg. I think Northeastern wants we the seven games in days to keep their starting position. You know, their whole team played in double-digit minutes yesterday against McGill. So definitely, at least on the Northeastern side, I think they're probably going to see every single body play.
Interesting about that, this is a very balanced spot in terms of scoring. If you look at last year's stats, there are 84 different instances of us scoring in double figures. Jonathan Lee did so at 28 of 31 games, whereas Joel Smith reached it 20 times, 64 did 19 times as a rookie. So again, a very balanced back and on. And it's no coincidence that those three were in top scoring on the team last season. And the top one there, Jonathan Lee, not even averaging 15 a game.
And so far, we're seeing defense is nothing to laugh at either. Solid defense early on in this one. Ottawa leads 15-13.
And that was only the second example of suspect selection I've seen from the Huskies thus far. They've mixed up pretty well. There was 1-3 earlier, I can't remember who took it, but it was kind of stepped into it and watched it, you know, only 5 seconds on the shot clock. Reminder to our American viewers, if you're just tuning in, they're saying 30-second shot. It is kind of halfway between the NCAA's 35 and CIS, which falls people from the last 24. Wide open for a three, and the man who shot better than 50% of inside and outside the arc is not going to miss too many of those being wide open.
Well, earlier in the playoff, we're trying to get the pick and roll going as an easy layup for Joel Smith there, Greg. But earlier in that last session, Ottawa trying to run pick and roll. Big man here, Nelson, trying to get into some plays, but so far the guard has not chosen to pass the rolling big man. We see another pick and roll here up top. And again, Johnny Brandeskell using the pass up. Instead, drinking free, Greg.
Yeah. Nelson with no screen on the play, knowing that Johnny has the ability to create his own shot, whether that be inside or a little bit outside. And the shot was a little bit contested. The defense second by Joe Smith in the cutter. He drops contact with go to the line, and 7:56 remaining here in the first half, and the Huskies, you know, feeling probably less than Husky right now after playing three games in 3 nights and a Carlton meeting for them tomorrow. You know, this is the third time out of the half. Perhaps they're maybe the fatigue get to the middle.
Well, I'm pretty impressed so far with number 20, Joel Smith, best play so far. I've missed a couple of long distance jump shots, but you know, he still took it hard to the rim last play there, and created a good scoring opportunity for Chris Kavanaugh, number one, who will be going to the line after this meeting at a few timeouts. And so far, I'd say that you know, it hasn't been too much to see these two teams play so far in this game.
That's pretty bad. I mean, like to see if the GG's trying to be a little bit more aggressive on a couple of possessions. They got that one, but unfortunately there was a shot clock violation here. GG's been on the play. There have been a couple of tough shots. As I said, you know, a couple minutes of knocking down. But so far so good when you're dropping 21 points against a formidable major opponent. You know, looking to cut some teeth. You know, with some hungry rookies on the squad for the future. Yeah, it makes the GG's release, of which there are six, by the way. You know, even hungrier themselves.
Well, we were impressed by a couple of rookies yesterday on the Ottawa side. Greg, obviously, boys making some starters minutes in the absence of starting guard Warren Ward. And obviously, Warren rehabbing that knee, trying to come back into the lineup once the regular season starts. Of note, Plunkett, a 6'6", small forward from Midhurst, Ontario, 10 points yesterday, Greg, including a couple of corner threes, so I'm sure we're impressed with that. We'll see how he factors into tonight's game. Matt on the floor right now, number 9 on your screen.
3-key right there for the Huskies. On additional turnovers you do not want to have in your down 6 on the road. J.B. Dehany, the Gloucester, Ontario rookie. And had a tail of Gata. Robert Ismail. A little 5-6 connection right there. And D.C. Bucket by Quincy Ford will count. It will.
That's 6'8", Quincy Ford, one of the taller players on the floor, just able to penetrate and get a nice little layup attempt close to the basket. As we've mentioned, Gabriel Gonti, who's probably the main post for Ottawa, standing at 6'6", so two-inch height difference made it a little easier for Ford to get the shot he wanted close to the basket.
Ford ranked third in scoring in the NCAA conference play last year and was named to the All-Rookie team. And combined with Reggie Spencer, combined for 3 Rookie of the Week winners in the Colonial Athletic Conference.
Fast break opportunity up. GG's Greg, Northeast ball, Eastern.
Shot clock reset on the play. Ball in for a 3 from the corner. It was a little short. Joel Smith kind of angled up to his side. It was not totally square. Raheem McDowell with a deep NBA 3, no good. On the wing, a nice feed, and that's up in the air. Back down with 40 for Rico off the bench. Woodstock Jordan Native is a freshman. 10-6-5 in the wing for the Huskies this year.
Well, he went to get it up there, Greg. Put it down.
In the corner by Joel, the transfer. Rebound right back into the hands of the Athletic Pack. And he threw it away to Johnny Pemiscal, the hot potato back and forth. to Henny, to Ishmael. Gigi's working around the rookies. Good on this possession. Rebound all down by Smith. I believe it's Ishmael that knocked the ball out of his hand from behind. Battery lost control on his own. Either way, 23 on the clock. 5:44 to go, and Gigi's down to a 23-20 lead. Smell a little bit of blood. And we'll take a quick break ourselves. We're going to check the Twitter. We're encouraging you Boston fans from Boston to outbeat the UNLV fans yesterday. Got their team trending on Twitter, so it's a challenge. Stay tuned, guys. We'll be right back. Welcome back, everyone. 23-20 GG's. Step back jumper, a tough one for Jonathan Lee, but he makes it stick. GG's block one. Mike Patrick Kane well aware of this. Trying to take care of the ball. GG's running a half court step. He got 10 seconds to try and make this a two possession lead. Ball inside, they find a little bit of real estate. Gontier, you're asking for a foul right there. 24 says no. They give and go inside the lane, and blowing the layup was the respect.
Again, beautiful facilitation by Joel Smith, trying to do that the other end with it. Almost picking off that pass there. Covered by Gontier, that putback.
Make it stick this time, after under 5 minutes to go. In the first half, he's still leading by three. Three-team foul for the G's, two for the Huskies. Not a lot of fouls so far, some decent flow. That kind of top charge right there is Quincy Ford, who we were just talking about right there. Great season last season. He was also named the mid-major freshman All-American team. And he was among 25 freshmen nationally and one of just two CAA players to be named to that squad. Ottawa. Another name to look out for. Mike Walker came to the OUL rookie team. Of course, for his first last year. GG's 28-24 lead. Coming up is Jonathan Lee. Team right there. He's recovered back on defense. Huskies turn around. Free throw line jump, no good. GGT, all down the board. Game slowed down a little bit to a couple of half-court sets. Team is recognizing that close one. Ishmael misses a jumper. Trying to go back, successfully throw around the world with Joel Smith.
And Northeastern not letting the GG set up their defensive So pushing the basketball, and after seeing we talked about a lot of games for Northeastern in a very short period of time, but they're not going to run.
Dunk at the bucket of Midhurst, Ontario for the GGs at 6-6. Some pick for the team steps up and drills that, but the Huskies right back, and it's a two-point game. 3 minutes to go in the first half, and up to the basketball fans, and we're hoping for a repeat of this in the second half.
Again, GGs going to have to tighten up their transition defense, two back-to-back. It's another, we're going to see another fast break. Sure. The Huskies not going to push that ball.
Really hung on for it, and that's their travel or foul. I just missed the call. Media time put called on the floor.
Media time, great.
We'll take a pick as well. 2:38 to go. Gigi's up 30. 2:28. Back to you in a few. Welcome back to 36 left in the first half. GG's Huskies. Aaron is in Canada. Thank you for joining us. Great call. Good day. The call has been Burton producing and it's on camera. Keeping this very, very close game steady. Minutes at the lines. Midi to Hanny goes high off the glass. Doesn't go. Huskies all over the rebound. I just slow things down right there. Man. Force an issue off the glass against the smaller defender, Quince Ford, a good basketball hit from him, as we are down 2 minutes remaining in the first half. Clafferton has played most of the half. Steps up that jumper well short. They got worked here, 2-on-1, and no contest as up and under. That was Jonathan Lee.
Well, Northeastern taking the lead, 2-3 with under a minute and a half left to play here in the first half, and doing it by really pushing the basketball. They're doing it with the first 10 seconds of the shot clock. We've noticed a couple of plays now. Now it looks like they're going to slow it down, mix it up, but really pushing the basketball. So when Northeastern runs, it looks like they're effective.
Trying to grab that ball back, it was loose for a bit. He's getting another chance. The 3-point goal has gone through the two sides above a couple of Huskies. Timed that perfectly and hold it down. It's very much a timing issue rebounding, and that is a perfect example. Handing out to Mike out left. Both of them coming off screens. One of them hits it, and it's made to Handy. 35-32 for the Colonel by Cougar. Now in Garnet Moore.
Local product of an Ottawa Spring roster. And getting some minutes, making the most of his minutes in this game break.
All swung way across court. That is a three from Joel Smith. Again, on the team last year averaging 13 a game. Also averaged 34 minutes a game. So pretty much the sub 6 minutes playing almost the whole game last year. We are down to 13 seconds, 35-35. Razor close game. Mike Lafferkin tries to go around, denied by the help defense there at the top. Steal, lost the ball, and there's going to be a foul on Jonathan Lee with the reach-in. 28 seconds to go. A good foul, because it stops things. No team is in the penalty. And GG left inbounds, 28 seconds left. Johnny Vickerskill will have the honors. Vickerskill comes out, 2 seconds to go off the screen. Johnny Vickerskill will not the shot off. The GGs have to come to their effort. Getting into the half tied with the Northeastern team that really took it to them, pushing.
First half, with that, we're going to step away for 15 minutes. Please join us for the second half here on SSN Canada. Greg, every day for live at Montpetit Hall, Ottawa UPG's basketball.
Montpetit Hall, everyone. 35-35 between the GGs and the visiting NCAA Huskies from Northeastern University. In the heart of Boston, a special welcome to the fans of the Huskies watching this evening from the great city of Boston, or wherever you're watching from. And of course, to all the GG fans out there, also watching from all over the globe. Give a shout out to Hannah Stanley-Paisley, who was watching it from the Germany yesterday. That player in women's history here for the program led the team to a berth in the semifinal last year of the Nationals, and he was playing in Germany's contract. So Hannah, if you're watching, I know it must be about past midnight right now, but get your play watching. What's up, how are you? GG's scored the first basket here of the half, 37-35. A reminder, you can tweet at my address, and of course, accounts for Dave as well. GG Ottawa is the Twitter address. The hashtag is GoMU. Those fans who would like to be part of the conversation, we will read your tweets. I can't respond to them on the device here. So as you call them the game, and we're having a lot of fun. And we will chat back on the air.
Well, and both training baskets here at the stadium of the second half. A couple of halftime stats for you, Greg. Talked about living and dying by the three-point shot. You putting 19 three-point field attempts, shooting 36%, making seven of them, obviously. And you're compared to Northeastern's seven attempts, 2 minutes. So we see all of you taking a lot more chances from beyond the arc. He scores Jonathan Lee, obviously, Northeastern, Joel Smith, Zach Dahl, each, putting seven up on the board, as well as Quincy Ford, so he bounced attack for Northeastern in the first half.
Well, Ishmael knocks down three, reestablishing some record there.
And on the GG side, obviously, Mojima starting off 35 points this quarter, but Gabriel Gomes, we talked about Ottawa, he was the strongest post player, playing on 7 boards on his own. 7 of 18 rebounds for him in the first half, and Ottawa being led off the starting point guard, number 11, Mike Lafontaine, 7 points to assist for him in the first half. So that's the tale of the stats for you, Greg.
David, the legend of everything, including the stats. This is just one more reason to the Twitterverse out there why we need to get paid for it on Twitter. You should look up and see if the legend D is a name that you can claim. I would be your first follower if you give me the honor.
As long as you create a Greg the Icon Gallagher account, and I'll be there.
Tell you what, if Kevin gets on Twitter, will you, Kevin, our producer and Cameron, if he gets on Twitter, will you go on Twitter, Dave? Live on the air,
I'll consider it. If he gives me a nod, I'll consider it. Oh, I don't
know. Oh, no, Kevin doesn't want Twitter. All right, then, I'll be the other go-to for Twitter for the time being. We'll keep working on it.
Open only.
There can only be one, says Kevin. And that, there can only be three from that category on the floor. Tying the thing up at 44.
Joel Smith
knocking it down.
Joel Smith, 10 field goal attempts in the first half. I talked about his aggressiveness. Joel Smith as well for his team, so suspect that coach is liking his.
We are coming up on the 4-minute mark. We understand there is a rough bench. There is a little bit of choppiness in the feed. To that person who let us know, it could be your computer. It could be us. We're aware and letting us know. Thanks to everyone for tuning in this evening. Still a tie game. A lot of lead changes in the first half, and that one really came down by Reggie Spencer. Zach. Hall, he's starting to assert his presence here in the second half.
Zach Stahl-Gregg was pointed out to us at the beginning of this game. Solid performance by this freshman early on in this seven-game northern road swing for Northeastern. Very, very consistent play on his part. Put up 7 points for the Huskies in the first half and just made five stats in the second.
Johnny Brahim-Skell quickly caught and released that ball instantaneously. Moments after falling to bound, managing to avoid four Huskies while passing it back to the top of the key before readying himself for a give and go. So again, the NU looking to assert themselves. They're pretty strong first half, shooting 50%. They attempt a lot of three-pointers. They're very economical. And as we said before, this team very balanced in scoring. Lots of doubles. Last season for this team.
A couple of interesting stats here, Greg. The numbers don't tell the full story, but you not getting to the line at all in the first half. Again, talked about 19 three-point attempts. More doubling Northeastern's attempts from beyond the arc. So really, you're not really attacking the basket that much. And just saying hi to our future Ottawa U basketball players here. But Ottawa U maybe needed to go inside a bit more, driving the lane. Did that be used to play?
But we see her there on camera right now. Perhaps we're going to say 2042 all key team. And what's her name? Naya is going to be on the all-rookie team in 2042, so look for her in GG colors.
Future Ottawa U GG.
Big fan. Looks like she's a very good passing on, too.
Yes.
Yeah. 4.5 minutes here into the second half. GG's down to... It's got to be the concert group. 46 apiece for these... There have been more changes than Dennis Rodman hairstyles here in this game. From the corner, that is short for Joel Smith. He's got 10, he's got 4 rebounds so far.
Continues to be aggressive, Greg. I think he's a playmaker for this team.
Yeah, he certainly got a balance attack. He took 5 of the team's 7 3-point attempts in that first half. Leads right there, points per game, free throw percentage, assists per game, and steals per game in CAC stats last year. 6 seconds on the shot clock, turn it down, it's always male. 49-46.
If I'm not mistaken, that's points for him in the first 6 minutes of this half. Montpetit coming out, guns blazing.
It's been Ismail and Saul out. Saul had a good start for the Huskies. It would be interesting if Saul has at least one sibling in NCAA. You know, when you look at Saul's in NHL, there's 4 of them. And I believe 5th on the way. Or I think either way there is a 5th Saul brother. So if there's at least one Saul brother, if someone can tweet at us and let us know, I think that would be super interesting. And the name isn't spelled the same. I think there ought to be at least one Saul in every major sport. Two, in fact, even up with numbers.
Right you are, Greg. And Jonathan Lee taking it strong to the basket with beautiful acrobatic layup there for Northeastern.
Cab Johnson Midgrid takes it on the high post extent, turns around, extends his left hand, lots of extensions on that one. 51-48. Like Dave getting extensions on the paper, on a lot of the term papers in the undergrad. Reggie Spencer answers on the other end. GG's still up by one as if we are 6.5 minutes gone here in the second half. Gab catches it in, just rolled off his fingers.
substitutions on the play, Greg, and so far I have to say I'm pretty pleased with both sides. I came out with good energy and putting the ball in the basket. Home team leads 51-50, 13-35 left to play in this basketball game. So far, a competitive game, a couple of lead changes between these two teams.
Jonathan Lee led the game scoring and brought it up there. Gets it back to the top of 13 seconds. Whipping people away as he wants to ice it right here with big skill. Good match rather right there. 24 strikes to the bucket for an easy dish and easy slam. 24, 3-5, shooting for 7 points in the first half. Added a rebound, an assist, and a turnover. Played 17 minutes. Up with the average much of last year, as you mentioned, it was one of 25 freshmen honored, you know, top freshmen at major schools we're speaking of last season.
I think he definitely had the body type to be a very good basketball player.
Ball again. Making presence foul. The second time is no good, but guilty party underneath. Looks like it's going to be Matt Nelson. It is. Nelson gets the foul called the chop. Nelson is going to go to the line.
Just wanted to mention, Greg, that last play, that toss up under the basket reminded me of last night's game, or yesterday afternoon's game against UNLV, where UNLV had a chance to put the ball into the back. And the GGs wanted to do outsize down low, just really trying to tap that basketball out. So, toss up under the basket, the GGs doing everything they can to try to get the big body in there and get the long arms to pull down the defensive rebound, but as we see here, the Northeastern able to convert at least, I guess, some points off of the free throw line, but again, all we use have to do a better job at boxing out after the shot attempts and really protecting their goal.
Definitely post-play that to be the difference along with the shots in the fourth quarter. That left the G's giving it away. And look at this, a clear path to the basket. And Derrico back with his second flush of the game. Yep. Kind of going with the Gordy Howe hat trick of dump, so to speak. I guess the third there would be a value to himself. More into the game. Hold over right there.
You could be a strike out amongst
probably. Unless you're talking about Xbox, you should see my 720.
That's right. Incredible.
Matt Plunkett, it's stolen away. In the hands of Demetrius Seymour. Hill and four DGs have touched on the possession. High screen for Johnny Brahim. Scully's got a little bit of room to operate. Looking for someone to pass to Gill. He thought he'd let it go quick at some point. Right into the hands of three Huskies. And taking the charge in an open court is Demetrius Seymour.
The guy who's not good.
One of his feet were moving. I don't mind that call. It was called by the referee. But he's into it. Gets the ups from his teammates. And this is a mobile step away quickly. 47 to go in the second half. GG's down 3 is 56. 53 for the Pistons. We'll be right back. Welcome back, everyone. The visitors have retaken 6-53 lead. 10.5 minutes to go, 9.5 rather. And to be certain, Husky is looking to take over here. He's having a big pass.
Well, again, Husky's with a bounce attack. Joel's having a 9-point start to this half. First 10 minutes of play. On the flip side, Mo Ishmael, number 6, playing well for the Ottawa UGGs. 8-point half so far. So a couple of players are really making their mark on this early on in the second half, Greg.
He's looking to stay in it. And turnover there by the Huskies will help. 14 fouls for the GGs in the half. Again, very very low stats-wise on average compared to the game in terms of fouls. There are only 5 fouls in 2 games in the first half. Ball inside, Johnny Brahim is fouled, leaning to the side after creating some space. Short on the jumper. Huskies looking to make it a 2-possession game. Powering into the lane right there is Quincy Ford. A nice finish. He's got 9. And the Huskies got 58.
Again, Quincy Ford, another player making his mark. He's now got 9 points in this ball game.
Johnny again looking for someone to pass to. The offense a little sticky on that possession. Quick on the mark is Quincy Ford stealing it away. And maybe it's worth the foul. A heads up play by Ford as Johnny Brain has held the ball a little too long. Looking to someone to pass to, but they got to make some movement to get those screens going, something.
Well, Coach James Jarwin, for all of you, recognizing the offense is a bit stagnant, bringing in 3 players into the ball game. Number 4, Gabriel Gontes, Bruno, and Matt, and their starting point guard, Mike Lafreniere. Mike Lafreniere already did 13 points, 3 assists in this ball game. Bring a couple GGs to bring GGs back here from the 6-point deficit.
Quincy Ford last year, 23% free throw shooter. When you combine conference and non-conference games, as a team, shot 70% last year, and their opponents shot 69%. So that had 1% difference between them and opponents, negating a sort of advantage. Probably factored a little bit into their 9-9 conference play when you take it and take the close games into account.
Let's two steals back on 2 different possessions for the GGs. We got getting into the lane in the last possession, and Mike Lafreniere picking that ball up for this possession. GGs unable to convert last time on offense. Let's see if this possession is any different.
No luck feed there from Johnny Brimis. The Gab Gontes. That did not happen. A couple of GGs there, and a little bit and voicemail running. Running into each other.
I think that was a David Walker with a beautiful behind the back on Johnny Brown's kill running with the quarterback. That could have been a very pretty play if I had been able to control the ball a little bit more.
Fortunately for the GG, that did not happen. That jumper a little too far back forward. And that ball, if there was no wall, that would have been sent into the 20th row. Huge block on the play. That was Ford.
David Walker. David Walker, not sure he got any, he got 5 minutes of playing time in the first half, Greg. Two pretty athletic plays so far in this half.
Beach is 3.
John Brain, that's 8 for Ottawa's shooting. Now with 9 points.
Ball rolls out the rim right there, and Stahl is going to go to the ball.
of key players in their roster. Chris Anderson, a defensive stopper for Ottawa U, but also an aggressive player who can take the ball to the basket, ability to penetrate the lane. Also, arguably the GG's best player, Warren Ward, nursing his knee back to health after an ACL injury, and his incredible start last season. With Warren back in the lineup and Chris back in the lineup, Greg, that might allow the GGs to drive the lane a little bit harder than they have been.
Pushed there by Tall. And Gab, yes, Chris Anderson, the G's best perimeter defender, very good to point out to the Huskies viewers tonight. GG's Robin Flood is the best defender in their best scorer in this game. Playing in. 61-56 for the Huskies. We gained that double lead for the second time.
He's pretty big, going really deep into their bench, being ready to cement here this evening, and doing the same thing against McGill last night. Coaching staff trying a bunch of different lines, using this as obviously a cultural visit to the national capital of the country, but also opportunity to try a couple of different plays. Drain the three from the corner for Ottawa U, bringing the lead, the Huskies lead down to 2.
And GGs have up some fouls here. 7-3, they lead the foul count. Quickly back the other way is Patsy Ford, quieting the comeback, at least for now. Mike left chance to save that. He's got 20 seconds to start with. Gonti trying to break free on the low block. Scores up to the baseline, and that looks like a travel. And that is the call. He was extremely excited to take that first step and go towards the lane to probably go for a tee shot that wasn't working.
Well, Coach James Harmon recognizing Gabriel Gonti-Zuru towards the end of last season really got it, and the lights turned on for him. He became a very effective scorer and rebounder for the GGs at the end of last season, averaging 16.9 rebounds towards the end of last season. But Sherman wanting an ISO play for going on that last play, but like you said, he got a little excited and ended up traveling on play. We're going to take a quick 20-second timeout. Huskies lead 63-59. Less than 8 minutes left in this ball game. We'll see you in 20 seconds.
Welcome back. 63-59 is the score. Just under 8 minutes to go. Mike Gallagher, myself, and Dave with the call. Kevin Burton producing and doing camera here on this. And happy to have you with us on a lovely August evening here in the capital. Temperature in the low 20s. Low 70s, I believe, for immigrants. But it's hot in here. 69 Huskies have just scored another bucket. Some contact on the ball there, and either an elbow or a travel right there. And the Huskies have turned over again. just want to give a obviously, since it might be dark in the fall. Fulcrum is for English language newspaper. They're here tonight. Fulcrum underscore sports is their Twitter address. They're here tonight. You can pick up that paper every Thursday on campus. I used to write the paper. But kind of, if you're a comm student or just want to volunteer and stay involved in campus. And La Redonde is the microphone newspaper. It's out on Mondays still on campus, I believe. So, here's your friend, you got a chance to get your writing skills to use. You pick up those two fine publications.
Great ball movement by Northeastern, moving that ball extremely effectively. And more importantly, Greg, getting the ball inside the paint. So this is something that Northeastern has prevented a lot of you from doing, and that's really getting the ball deep inside the paint. As we see, it keeps swinging it around, going to Abdel, going to Zubir, but again, settling for that outside shot. This time, Ishmael able to connect on three. Gigi with the five, but what are the Gigi's going to do in terms of getting that ball inside the painted area?
Certainly got to try a little harder. It's not for a lack of effort. GGP might be a little bit tired there, you know, from a lot of looks and stuff. But he's really had to struggle to create some space, even off the low block. He's had a battle for some tough defending just to get the ball. And he stopped rushing it there, you know, a couple of possessions ago. He had to, like, a travel call because he was trying to make that first step and create some space. So I think it's just a matter of plugging away, but they're certainly facing a good interior defense. And it's only a 5-point game. 5-29 goes, 67-62 is the score. Let's see if the free throw line becomes a stretch.
Well, again, when you take the ball inside, good things happen. And number 8 for Ottawa, Johnny Brainwell actually did drive the lane, but he drove and he kicked the ball back out to the shooters. A couple of missed jump shots for the GGs, but it's probably got it a double-digit rebound in this game, and we'll go back and get to the line. We talked about how Ottawa U did not get to the line a single time in the first half, so again, good things happen when you go inside, especially for the GGs in this game. Northeastern doing a terrific job in defense to keep the GGs out of the key.
This is Mapp's first trip to the line tonight. Knocked down one of two. We are just over 5 minutes to go. It's a 4-point game. Low scoring game too, but 35-35 at halftime. GGs were also up by 3 against UNLV last night or yesterday afternoon. A dribble from side to side and a quick first step propels Jonathan Lee. As he now has 14, that's a game high. Joel Smith, actually, he's got 16. And leading the GGs is Mo Ishmael and Mustafa Kane. At our last update, Mo had 13 points. I'm not sure if that included that 3. If so, he had 16 and had tied the game. 4-3 left. Mustafa Kane hounded by perimeter defenders right there. A hustle back to the response on the floor for the Huskies. The challenge, the regroup. That's proven to be a huge difference in their off-the-ball play.
Absolutely. Well, the perimeter D is tight on the GGs. I think that the Huskies are realizing that the GGs like to shoot it from three. And I got to give Joel Smith a bit of a look there as he shot the three in his eye. But definitely the Huskies perimeter D is tightening up on the GGs, recognizing that they like to shoot the basketball. And,
that's a tough guard. Tough guard for Michael Afrikaner. Joel Smith is 6'4", big guy.
Last night's career, Reggie Spencer going left for the Huskies in the last.
JD, 13 on the clock. Still coverage, but still tries to set him a pick. A pick and roll that is, and Vickis misses badly at a critical time in the game. It's now a 5-point game. That bucket on the other end. Black Northeastern, and they can start. A huge deck right here, score in the possession. Stahl, he had a great start to his first half. He's right in there trying to keep it alive. Mike Lockford came, plays a loose ball. Huge position for the G's with exactly 3 minutes remaining on the clock. Stahl away from the ball, or rather a timeout. Ottawa wants to call time with 22 seconds left on the shot clock. Just under 3 left on the game clock. 71-66 Northeastern. We'll be back on X10.
Mail, Mike Patrick came to Ibrahim as well. And Vickis Gill and Gab Montier to front court. Bad shot selection there for Gab. A little bit out of his range. I guess they have to get something up, but gotta get that movement going against a tough defense like the Huskies. That could prove to be the difference if they score here. Tough possession like that.
Gigi's got to close up on the that was a bad offensive possession for them. Again, Jonathan Lee scoring at will, getting inside, driving that lane, and it's been a huge skill for the GGs here tonight. We'll get into the lane, but it's Mike Lafferty driving the lane. But again, another turnover for the GGs.
Jonathan Lee last year, obviously a huge year, we talked about all those doubles and the Colonial Athletic Conference had as many as the average star there, perhaps even more. 32 minutes a game he played last year. 47% shooting from the field and nearly 42% from three. This guy can shoot. Not quite 80% from the free throw line, but of course led the team scoring a 14.5 game last season.
GG, you're going to head back to this ball game, Greg. Can have your post players shooting three-pointers and have to keep moving the basketball. That's Northeastern doing extremely well in the second half. Swinging the ball, getting a lot of touches for a lot of players. And as you look at it, updated since the game. Zach Stahl, again the freshman, lighting it up the floor in this game with 19 points in the ball game. Again, it's been a bounce attack for Northeastern University. Cole Smith, 16 points. Jonathan Lee, 16 points. And, combined with 2017 rebounds. So, really good things happening here for Northeastern in this ballgame. Really happy to be with us.
Well, three players in double figures. Mo Ismail leading, tied with Michael Hurricane, in fact, both at 16 points. Michael Hurricane adding on 4 assists. But we will try to get Michael Hurricane. He's our choice for interview after the game. If we can't get him, we will try for Mo Ismail or one of the other top performers in the GDC. Stay tuned after the game for that. As soon as the crowd clears, we can get him up to our camera. We'll have some questions for him. Up on 2 minutes remaining, Northeastern by 7. Ball thrown away, could be a 4 or 5 point swing right here if Michael African and the GGs can convert. Because huge three, I think he forced that one a little, it was nowhere near the mark. Dick's a little off tonight here in the second half, that's when he hit this badly. This one very close to being over. Running some clock here. That's east. Jumper no good off back iron for Joel Smith. One of two players with 16 points. Jonathan leads the other for NU. Leading the way, of course, that's all this half. Who's had a good second half? He's got 19 points and 9 rebounds.
Just tonight, 20 more 3-point field goal attempts. Northeastern University, so the GGs maybe a little over-reliant on that 3-point scoring option and converting on 41%. It's still not a bad shooting percentage, mind you.
That was Quincy Forlop giving go from the top. He took the third bucket. Little buddy back. Them out of bounds. He knocks these down at two. Effectively over. GGs will not foul eventually. GGs second trip to the line at 73% from the line last season. Best threes for shooting on the team with Joel Smith. Shooting a hair above 88%, which is excellent. Ball into the hand of Clive for Kane. A running jumper, tough shot, he knocks it down. Too late, probably. He's pressing 3-4 court, and there is the foul. They have no more to give. Huskies are in the bonus.
75-68 with 32 seconds left in this ballgame. Huskies lead. University of GGs. Overall competitive game, Greg. Again, I think the Huskies wore the GGs down a little bit, especially in the second half, and saw some pretty good play system. Some aggressive play. Jonathan Lee, who happens to be on right now, effective at getting to the basket, making a couple of layups. But...
29 seconds to go. We'll drop to 0-2 on their preseason schedule. Next up, we'll come in September, preseason games. Northeastern is going to move on to Carleton tomorrow. It's going to be their fourth game of the eight games, of the seven, rather. Of course, they're playing seven games in 8 nights. Quite the travel schedule, too. They were in Quebec City a couple days ago. Took a two-hour bus ride to Montreal. Did McGill. Another two-hour bus ride here. Said they were at the communications
got for Husky said earlier they were in Chester Hotel, a meal or two, you know, played their game, popped on the bus, didn't have much chance to see Montreal. And that's what happens when you travel. Shower, get on the bus and go. And a lot of these teams get on the plane. Pass inside Gap Grades, Burr and Zach Stahl. Who's been huge, especially in the second half. To put it out.
The story for me is the lockdown defense of the paint and with each team today. And, I'm hoping to ask Mike Lafontaine and the GGs about it after this game, Greg. But overall, a good performance by the GGs team, who's learning to play together, a lot of rookies on this team. And overall, I think the GGs should be happy with this performance. Northeastern, very good team. And a good basketball game.
79-70 is the final. GGs dropped over 2 in the preseason. Speaking of Provino, stand by, folks. We will take a quick break while the crowd thins. We'll try to get Mike Lafferkin or another GG player up here, so just talk with us. 2 minutes time. Welcome back, everyone. Just moments after 79-70 loss for the GGs to the Northeastern Huskies. We're here with Mike Lafferkin. 16 points. I'm second on the team tonight. 20, my mistake. I just adding on the numbers. Mike, your thoughts. Tonight have lost a couple of close games over the preseason.
It's just the same thing both games. We're playing with them. We're tied at halftime, up three at halftime. We just got to figure out a better way without a very old team, so we got to find something to get going in the second half. I mean, the first half, I think we're doing an okay job. We're keeping up with them. And then the second half, we're just collapsing. You know, we need some veterans to step up. I think I need to step up. Some other guys need to step up, especially on the defensive end. Like, it's just the little things I think will be fine.
One of the things I noticed was that you took 20 more three-point attempts. Northeastern, obviously they're bigger and they've got size inside, but they're sort of inside a little bit more. I thought you drive the lane a couple of times and you were effective with layups and the basketball as well. But what about penetration into the game? Any thoughts on that?
When we penetrate, we got some finishers, but I think our biggest strength is that every single guy, I'd say 1 to 12 on our team, can shoot the ball. So, I mean, we can really shoot it, so when we penetrate, we're kind of just looking for the kick-up because a guy like Johnny, like lights out of the corner when he comes back. I think I'm an okay shooter. Can shoot Mo, Caleb. We got all shooters, so you're gonna see that this season. So I guess you're right. We gotta get to the thing a little bit more.
Well, first for you, I'm gonna ask Johnny yesterday. Not so far from rookies coming. A couple of big performances yesterday. Mo is especially today.
Yeah.
Especially with the injuries to key guys and Chris Anderson being out, at least for the foreseeable future for the rest of the preseason, missing in disguise for the rookie league sometimes.
Oh yeah, big time, because the only thing I think they're missing is that they're just not used to the game as much as well. They're very talented. I've known them since I was probably, you know, grade 9 or 10. They can play, they can really play, but they're just missing what I thought I was missing last year too, just a little bit of experience and toughness. They're really good players, and this is a blessing because preseason get them in shape with more crypto back, hopefully, and then go.
Okay, thanks a lot for this, and best of luck for the preseason.
Thank you very much.
All right, GD's guard, Mike Lafferkane, and Dave, your final thoughts is a couple of close clean points for the GGs as they head into the rest of the preseason.
Well, shout out to Chris Anderson, man, we gotta get him back here on the roster. He's a difference maker for the GGs, but overall, I think two competitive games so far. GG should be happy with the performance here tonight. As you heard Mike mention, they're learning, and they've got a lot of new rookies on the team, and I think that nothing things for the GG so far this season.
We'll see you in September for the schedule, of course, the Donahue. We will have it all on at the end. So for Kevin, for Greg, this is Dave. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you in as early as a